Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the fabulous Urban Graffiti AcryGel. I'm going to do a tip and overlay. I'm going to show you how to put a tip on and put this beautiful product on. I've already prepped the nail. We have a video just on prep that Adam will link here somewhere if you want to see that. But I'm going to go ahead now and apply a tip that I've sized up. Now it fits from side to side. I'm not going to push it up here. I'm going to bring it to around there. Just a couple of mil on the nail. So you want about a mil of product just sat at that contact area there. Press it on. Where's there.
Away.
Gotta stop this putting things away business. I'm just using some tweezers to just make sure those corners are stuck down. Then I'm going to cut the length.
It does look very organised over there, actually, doesn't it? Wow. That there.
For now. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to tailor this tip. By that, I mean I'm going to press in the middle, like that. And then I'm going to hold from here to here on this side. Give that a little pinch. Going to do the same on the other side, and then I'm going to gently roll it as well as I press. That will give you a C curve, so it's going to make the nail stronger, so the whole structure of the nail will be stronger. You can kind of just give that a little press and a little pinch to make your C curve nice. I'm going to take off the sides because we want to make this into more of a ballerina shape. So it can be achieved with a tip, because some people do think you've got to sculpt out a ballerina, but you don't have to. You can use a tip if you're used to tips and you know enjoy using tips, then it can be achieved. I know there's technicians out there that go, oh, I can't do your ballerina because I don't sculpt. We can do it with tips. I'm going to take a 180 grit file and blend the tip slightly. It doesn't need to be blended a lot because this tip has to be quite thin at the contact area. So we're going to take off the shine. It's really important to take off the shine off the tip because the AcryGel is going to adhere to the tip. If you put AcryGel onto a shiny surface, it won't adhere as good. It's all right for using for put stones on, because we've done that in previous videos, that's fine. But when you're doing a full extension, you need to abrase the tip. I'm just going to wipe over it with some pure acetone, and that will melt this area as well, so it'll blend it in a little bit further. Make sure you don't shine the nail tip. The acetone, watch this, will make it shiny. See? So when the acetone has made it shiny, you're just going to buff over and bring that back to matte again. You can dust that off. Nail prep dehydrator. You don't need to apply primer, but the next step is to put the Urban Graffiti base coat on. Now this just goes on the natural nail. It doesn't need to go on to the actual tip itself. And you want to put it on really thin. So your brush doesn't need a load of product on. So I'm dragging off a lot of the product, because you only need a little.
Some people have actually asked why you need to use a base coat with the AcryGel.
Because the base coat is the key to it. If you apply it straight onto the nail, it will peel off. It won't peel off a tip, but it will peel off a natural nail. So a nice thin coat. Pop that on. So it's like it's the sticky layer that sticks it to the natural
like
nail.
Like the acrylic liquid to the acrylic powder.
Do you have to do the same thing with hard gels as well?
Yeah, you have a base layer on. Okay. So normally you'd have like a pot of base. Then you build it. And then you top. So you do it in three stages. And this is kind of the same because you're putting a base on, you're putting the AcryGel on, and then you're putting the top coat on. So the colour that I'm going to use today is called Snug as a Bug. Snug as a Bug in a Rug. So Snug as a Bug, and it's a nice peachy beige colour. So I'm going to squeeze out. Then, so I've got like a little sausage. I do think it looks like the tube's having a poo. And I'm going to place it on slightly to the back. So it's not quite in the centre, it's a little way to the back. And when I mean the back, I mean close to the cuticle area. I'm going to take gel residue wipe off solution and clean my tool.
Oh, that noise is awful.
Nice. That doesn't go through me.
I like that noise.
You like it?
The hairs on the top like, just stood up.
Squeaky clean.
Yeah.
Hands that do dishes feel as soft as your face. Very liquid. That makes you go, don't do the squeaky clean.
But your voice singing.
Oh, it makes people's ears bleed. So what you're going to do now is in your dampened dish, you're going to put some of the gel residue wipe off solution. And this is the product that's going to make your brush not stick to the AcryGel. So you're going to get your brush and you're going to move it around. And look, it's not moving anyway. It's not moving anywhere. It only moves when you actually press it. So if you struggle with acrylic application or even hard gel application, this is definitely the product for you, because you know I could have a little conversation now and it's not going to go anywhere, it's just going to stay there. So you can just pattern press it. It's not going to set. I am going to pull a little bit of that off. Been a bit generous with my application.
When you're doing a full set,
of
these, and you've used too much, could you just pop it onto the other nail?
Yeah, you could. Yeah. You could. So you can keep titivating it. So you can see I built the apex up and everything. It's quite smooth. We're going to pop that into the lamp and cure that, and then I will show you the rest, and I'll show you how I actually apply it to all of the nails, and then I move it. So basically, I apply the product in my little blobs, blob, 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 and then I move the product. So when they come out, they will have a slight sticky layer. See that? Slight sticky layer. So we're going to take that off with the gel residue wipe off solution. So give them a little wipe over. Oh, yes. Do you like having a good clean today?
Oh, yeah. I'm back.
So I'm going to file the nail with my normal filing routine. So I'm using a 180 grit. No, not that's 100. Using a 180 grit file. You can use 100 grit if you want to, but it files really softly. And the beautiful thing about AcryGel is the dust is really fine, but drops really quick. So it actually drops out of your breathing zone, which has got to be a winner, because I don't fancy having lungs full of AcryGel. Obviously, you could wear a mask, but you don't need to, because look, it just falls. And it's really easy to file. I'm going to do that on all the nails. And then I'm going to go over with a buffer to smooth those out. I have nicked her. Can you see?
Oh, let's have a look.
If you look at JJ's hands, JJ's actually got a lot of dermatitis because she's allergic to certain hair products. So, she's under a consultant, she's being dealt with, so her skin is like paper thin, so it does cut very, very easily. So I'm going to clean that area up, and I'm going to use the gel residue wipe-off solution, and that will make it all clean as well. So wiping over all of the nails, I'm going to leave the one that's got the little nick till last. You know, save the best till last, of course. So you're cleaning the area at the same time. That colour is absolutely beautiful.
You could top coat that easily, couldn't you?
Yeah, you could top coat and just leave it like that. So that's a set ready for, you can just put a top coat on it, like JJ said, or you can put a gorgeous gel polish colour on. And what we'll do is, in another video, I was going to say the next video, but I don't know what order these videos are going out in, because it's up to him, not me. We're going to use this set to do some gel polish designs. So we're going to leave them like that. I'll just put a little bit of oil on just to replenish the oils in the skin. And then we're done. But yeah, I do think it's a beautiful product. Absolutely beautiful. Because it's so easy to file. It's so easy to work with. If you're a newbie, this product is definitely for you. And I think you could then progress on to doing acrylic nails. So there you go. There you go, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And my Snapchat is Kirsty Nails. Everything I've used today will be listed below, as always. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Keep watching. Bye bye. I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use, let me get the product, AcryGel. I'm going to show you how to bring it out over a tip. I'm going to do that again because that was a really intro.